Hi everybody, this is Ellen. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make my happy mushroom. I think he's super adorable. Kind of a big mushroom top and just a little face down here. I'm not sure about the big eyes yet, but I'm going to try little ones and see if I like those better on this. But I think they're both cute, and I think he just kind of like, he looks kind of sad with the big eyes. I think that's why he's not a happy mushroom. So we want to be happy. But band-wise, it's 254 red. I know it's so little, you're like, how does that many bands? And then 150 white, and then whatever you use for the eyes, cheeks, and the mouth. So, and then I did add about 10, there's 9 on this one, but I have 10 ready for the other one. Little wrap bands just for little dots on the top. So we'll get started. First, the little dots on the top and the cheeks, which are made the same way, are just a wrapped band, whatever color you want the dot to be. On your hook, wrap it around once to figure eight, grab both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through two bands that are going to be the mushroom top color. So like I said, I made about 10 of these, but they are optional. You don't have to put them on if you don't want to. And then the cheeks are made the same way. It's just whatever color you want the cheek to be on the hook, figure eight, grab both, wrap them around again, and then pull them through two bands that are the color of the stem on your mushroom. Like that. So you want two cheeks. And then the eyes, like I said, this time around I'm going to use smaller beads. These are the 9mm pony beads, but I'm going to use 7mm this time, and I can't thread the bands through without a little piece of craft wire, or you can use thread or floss or anything you can get into the V shape. Then you'll take two bands of the color of your stem, put them in the center, close it up, and then thread them through your bead and pull them down. Then you want two of them if you use like this. The larger eyes are, you can push the bands through when you get there. Or if you want to do a wrapped band for the eye, it's just one band for the smaller beads. And if you want them bigger, then you use two bands. But it's the same way. It's just, if you want a big eye or a little eye, one band for a little eye, two bands for a big eye, on the hook, wrap them around once into a figure eight. And then grab all four, if it's a big one, two, and then pull those through. So that'd be how you make a wrap band, eye band, if you want the bigger ones, and then if it's a smaller, you just use the one band, and they'd be the same as the cheeks. So, we got that done. Now, you'll want one loom, wrong end towards you. We're going to start kind of in the center here, with our color. I'm making a green one this time. I might have to make a purple and a blue and a yellow if you get my drift, like Mario Brothers. And then have your wrap bands on hand for how you want, because those are just randomly placed. So we're starting in the center, make a starburst. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seventh pin up from the center will be where I'll put a starburst, using my mushroom color. And a starburst is just from the center pin out to the six pins around. I know this one's been a long time in coming. Just have to have that inspiration. These are double banded, by the way. Cat hair. And then two bands on the cap band wrapped around three times. So 1, 2, and 3. Then you go in through that cap band, grab the top two bands wherever they are, pull them up through the center, and then back towards themselves. And you'll do that all the way around the outside pins. And yes, I know that in a power-up mushroom, well, power-up mushroom from, I should have white dots, but I'm going to make it yellow. So you have that. Now we're going to do two rows all the way around with two bands. So I'll just start down here, go around my starburst. Like that. Then I'll flip the bottom four bands on every pin. Push it down. Do another row all the way around. Two bands still. Better start throwing some of these in there before I forget. So like that, with a couple wrap bands added in. Flip the bottom four again. Now we are going to expand all of our pins. So I'm going to start over here on the right side. And for this one up here, I can just pick up the top two bands. And now they're, when I pick them up, the bands that are on my hook come around to this pin here in the center, so there's going to be no crossing of the bands. We don't want any crossing. So for this one, I can just pick up the top two and bring them up. But if I do that down here, they're going to cross. So what I have to do when that happens is I have to pick up all four bands, bring them back a pin, and then bring the top two back. So now there's no crossing right here either. And that's what we have to do on all the pins. If just kind of pick it up and you'll see. So this one on the left side, I have to pick up all of them, bring them up a pin, and then I can bring the top two back. No crossing. And then down here, I can pick up the top two and bring them down. And then for the middle pins, I'm just going to go in, grab the top two, whatever side they're coming from. So on my hook, they come and wrap around to this pin right here. I'm going to bring them over to that side as well. So these two should go over to the right side. And do that same thing up here, the top middle. Top two bands, they're on the left side, so they're going to go over to the left side. And the other two will go to the right. So now we are on 12 pins. And we are going to do three rows all the way around this whole section. So don't forget your little dots if you want those in there, your little spots. So first row all the way around. Still two bands. Just two. Random spot. So that's our first row around, and on this one you're going to flip the bottom two bands all the way around. Those down. Do our second row all the way around. More spots. Like that. So this is our second row, and this one will flip the bottom four on all the pins. Like so. And we have one more row. Tuck these in. So this will be our third row all the way around. Two bands still. Still adding in my little spots. I think it'd be cute to make like a white mushroom with little rainbow spots. Be cute. Like that. Then flip the bottom two all the way around again. Oops. Flip the band off. Stay on your pins. Push those down. So now we need to increase just a little bit more, and we want to increase the third pin up on the right side and then the last pin. To increase this one, I'm going to actually pull all three of these pins back one pin. Don't pull back, but that's because I know how I put the bands on. I need to do that. But when you get to this third pin, before you pull it back, just check the top two bands and see where they're coming from. My top two bands are coming from up here, so I know that I want the top two bands on this pin, so I have to move all four of them down a pin and then move the other two back. But if these two bands, if you put them on the opposite direction, then you'll just want to pick up the top two bands and bring them down. We don't want the crossing. That's what we're avoiding. So like that. Then up here at the top, I can just pick up the top two bands, pull them up a pin. You might have to move all four up and then bring the top ones back. And then on the come around this other side, and we want to move these three pins back. So one, two, and then again check here before you move it to see where your top bands are. I know I need to move all of mine. You still want any crossing right here. So then come all the way down to the bottom on the left side. And for this one, I have to pick up all four, bring them down a pin, and then bring the top two back. So when we look at the side here, 4, 4, 2, 2, 4, 4, 2, 2. Other side, 2, 2, 4, 4. 2, 2, 4, 4. So now we're going to do two rows all the way around. Still double banded. Like that. So when we flip, you're either going to be flipping the bottom four or the bottom two. You just want to leave four bands on the pin once you flip over the bottom ones. So 4, 4, 2, 2, 4, 4, 2, and two. And then the other side, two, two, four, four, two, two, four, and four. I'm just going to pull this up here. Push everything down. Then we have one more row all the way around. Two bands still. Still have one more little spot to put on. Probably could have used a couple more, but that's okay. You shall go here. Like that, and then flip the bottom four all the way around. Push those all the way down to the bottom of the pin. So now what we're going to do, to get the edge that pokes out, that is firm, we're going to do the little, I know I call it an X row, but what we want to do is, first we're going to take two bands, we'll put them on the pin, but cross them, and we're going to do that all the way around. Doesn't really matter which way you cross, but just so that they're crossed. Like that. But now what we need to do is kind of push these down a little bit, because right on top of this we're going to do another row, two bands, just kind of normally straight across. You might have to push them down a little bit, like it kind of, it's a lot of bands on the pins, but it's not too bad, so. Hopefully you think so. So like that, we're going to have, let's see here, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 bands on the pin, and we only want to flip the middle four. So we have the top two, or the top four bands, it's hard to see right there, top four bands from this straight row that we just put on, and then you have the bottom four bands, which are from all this that we did before. And the middle four bands are from the cross row. The cross row is what we want to pull up over the top of the pin. And you'll do that all the way around. Just take your time so you don't grab anything you're not supposed to. So now you can kind of look through there and see that they're separate. This kind of little row that's over on the inside is separate from the bottom, and that's the way we want it to be. Just do that on both sides. Like that. So now what we want to do is we need to pull up the bottom band and then just kind of slide this one over. So how we do that, so I'm going to go through the top four bands on the pin, grab the bottom four bands with my hook, pull them up through the top four, and then I'll slide the four that are still on the pin off. And then the ones that are on my hook will go back onto the pin. And you're going to do that on every pin around. Pull them up through, slide those off. And just make sure that before you take your hook out, after you have them on the pin, that you have all four bands back on the pin. Because sometimes I miss one of them. Trying to push them back on. So you're leaving four bands on. Do the same thing on the other side. Just turn your loom whatever way is comfortable. Like so. I'm going to tuck these ends over the pin. Push your bands down. Now what we're going to do is do a transition row to go from the top color into the underneath color. So to do that, we need to make transition bands, which are just two bands that we put together. Like if I put them like this, I can grab the green one through the white one, and then I grab the white one through the green one, and you just kind of fold each one of them in half, and it makes a transition band or half and half band. When you put them on your loom, I want my top color, which is my green, to be towards the green, and you really want to make sure that your bottom color wraps around the pin as much as possible. And on the end, it's kind of hard to do just because of there's more space between than on the sides. If that's kind of confusing to do it that way, you can make them on your loom. Just pick one of your colors that you need and then pick the other color. And take your hook, go in through the top color, grab the bottom one, pull it back towards itself. Go in through that little spot, pull the other one back towards itself. And then I've made that same band on the loom that I did on my fingers. And then again, when you put it on, put the color, your top color next to the top color and your bottom color on the outside. And get the bottom color wrapped around as much as possible. And we'll do that all the way around. And then we just put the, try and get most of that color wrapped around the pin, because when we flip, a lot of times if it's not perfectly even, then it, you can see the little bands poking out, but really it's not crucial because it's on a spot that you wouldn't really see when you're just looking at it, so. But you want to do the best you can. You can always fix them later, but it's just kind of a pain to fix them. It's easier to do it well the first time. I still feel like I have my cold with me. Kind of hanging around longer than I would like. Look, maybe it's just allergies. Who knew? Alright, so now it should look like this. And then we'll just go and flip the bottom four all the way around. So then you should basically be left with what mostly looks like your new color on every pin. Like that. Push your bands down. Now what we want to do is reduce. So on the right side from the bottom, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. So this pin right here, we're going to reduce. So you want to pick up the top two bands and just kind of be aware they are the half and half bands. So find those top two bands, and then you're going to, mine are coming from up above, so I'm going to pull them down below. And then the bottom two bands, they're coming from below, so they're going to go above, like that. Then we want to do the same thing up on this last pin on the top right. Pick up the top two bands. They're coming from the left, so they're going to come over to the right. And the bottom ones, they are going to go over to the left. Like that. And then from the left side here at the top, 1, 2, 3, 4. This one we're going to reduce. Same thing, pick up the top two. Mine are coming from the bottom this time. So I'm going to pull them up to the top. And then the other ones I'm going to pull down. Then the last pin on the bottom left over here, we're going to reduce that one as well. So top two coming from the left, so they're going to go over to the right. And the bottom are going to go to the left, like that. So it should look like this now. Now we're going to do a row all the way around in our new bottom color. Mine's the white. And you have long stretches in a couple spots where we reduced, so kind of long across, and regular, regular, and then long, and regular, regular, long stretch across. Although it's really not much longer than normal, but then regular, regular, long stretch, regular, and regular. So like that. Then depending on the pin, you're going to flip the bottom six or the bottom four. So if you have the reducing band on there, it'll be six to flip, or it'll be four. And this is where you kind of want to, if you can, pull some of the bands over. Like, I just want the white to show, so I'll try and pull the white over and let the green kind of go back underneath. It's not perfect, but it's a nice quick way to change color. Go all the way around and do that. Like so. So it'll look like this. And what we want to do is just start moving this closer, because they're going to have to be closer anyways for when we get to the smaller part on the stem. So we're on the right side. I'm going to kind of start at this point that's out farther and just bring those back in a pin. Just be careful so you don't lose any bands. This is usually where I have trouble. Sometimes I'll miss a band getting it over the pin. So just take your time. Make sure you have all the bands over before you pull your hook out. So now those six are close. We're going to do the same thing on the other side, but on the opposite end. So I'm going to move the farther away and closer. Like so. I'm going to pull up my center a little more, unhook it. Be careful when you pull. Like that. Push down. And now that we have those all moved, we're going to reduce again, and this time we're going to reduce basically every other pin. So starting down here on the bottom right, I'm going to pick up the top two bands. Mine are coming from the pin above, so they're going to go to the pin opposite, and the other two, they're coming from over here, so they're going to go to the opposite pin. So we just do that on every other one, basically. So we'll skip where we ended our last decrease, go to the next pin up, grab the top two. They're coming from above, so they're going to go below. The other ones will go above. And we'll just do that all the way around. Just see where they're coming from and take them to the opposite pin. And come over the other side. Do the same thing. we want them to cross when we reduce, but when we increase, we don't. So like that. We're on 6 pins now. So we'll do a row all the way around. 2 bands. And there are long stretches between them. Like that. So then on every pin you're going to have 4 reducing bands to flip over, and then 4 from before to flip over. I think it's easier to flip over the reducing bands first and then flip over the bottom 4. Not quite as much tension on your hook. So like that. So then we again want to move these closer. So I'm just going to, we want them to be 3 pins on each side right next to each other. So I'm just going to pick up on the right side. I'll leave this one here and then move these 2 down. The long stretches, though they aren't bad, it can make your bands kind of stretch out a little more. Leave things bumpy, so we try to avoid those. So 3 on this side, and I'll move the other ones on the other side to the same pins across. So these up one, and this one down one. Like that. Awesome, it's so cute. So now we're on to the stem part. We're going to do 3 rows all the way around before we get to the face. So 2 bands all the way around. You just have to kind of push the top back out of your way. Like that, and flip the bottom 4. That's 1. Second row. The bottom 4. One more row. 2 bands. Flip the bottom 4 again. Push down. Now we are ready for the face. Those. So I'm gonna start two bands down here across. The eyes are gonna go in the spot right here. I'm using the little ones this time. And then two bands around the rest. Then flip the bottom four. Do a row just like that, but where the eyes were, we're going to put the cheeks. Two bands, and then our cheeks. And then two bands around the rest. Flip the bottom four. Right. Now we're ready to put the mouth on. And what I'm going to do is take my mouth band, put on my hook, wrap it around once to that figure eight, and I'll hold it, take it off my hook. Come up here in the front between the cheeks, stick my hook down in through the bands, hook my both the bands on that mouth band, pull it up through, and bring it up over the top of the pin. Then you can pull it down and flip it up over the top of the pin. So it looks like that. Push these down, and now we're going to do three rows all the way around with two bands. Flip the bottom four. Down. Second row around. Like that. Flip the bottom four. And one more row, all the way around. And flip the bottom four one last time. So it looks like that right now, and we'll address the elephant. It's much different. Once we get the loom, I'll show you the difference. So then we want to take this off. I'm just taking my hook, going through all the bands around. Careful, your last one always wants to pop off. So I have all those on my hook. Grab two bands. I don't know if I have any in this batch, but make sure that when you use the glow-in-the-dark white that they don't have any of the little dark spots on your clothing bands, because those spots are like, they're kind of like burns, but they come apart very easily. So make sure on your clothing bands that if you use the glow in the dark white, which is what I use all the time, that you don't have any dark spots on those, because they might snap, and that would make you very sad if you got all this way and it snapped. Close it off. Let's kind of flatten out the bottom. Pull tight. Hide your ends. Now, difference is that we're going to stretch this out, and then the just kind of get a point a little bit, and then it folds back inside itself to create a nice little dome hat. If you want, you can leave it tall, I guess, too, because there are mushrooms that look like this too, but so either way, it's fine, but I kind of like it when it looks like he has a little hat hiding in there. And I have to say that I think I do like, well, I don't know, now that they're close together. Small eyes, big eyes. I always figured the small eyes for the skinnier designs, but the big eyes are cute too. Love them both. Can't decide. You have to tell me what you think, and then I'll try and do that more often. So, super cute. And it's convertible. Have it whichever way you want. And for whatever reason, somehow magically, I don't know if it's just how I'm pushing it together because I want the face to show. It's kind of like the top of the hat tips back. And realistically, there's no reason why it should. But magic. Magic mushrooms. But I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. These guys are adorable. And I know people have been waiting for them for a long time. And I just thought it was time, so I'd share them. But thanks you guys so much for everything, for watching my tutorials, for showing me your designs after you make them, for just everything. It's amazing. I definitely appreciate it, and I am always trying to keep looming. It's very enjoyable and means a lot to me, so thanks you guys so much. Definitely share these with me on my Instagram, which is at craftingfantastic, or on my Facebook page, which is feelinspiffy or craftingfantastic. And then, of course, it'd be fantastic if you give this video a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel so you know when I come out with new things, which hopefully will be soon. But thank you so much, and happy looming.